There was a great sense of pride honoring a man whose ultimate sacrifice was to die for his countrymen. It's been four decades since former Philippine Senator Benigno Ninoy Aquino Jr. was assassinated on the tarmac of the Manila International Airport, sparking a people power revolution that ousted the dictatorship of Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Those feelings of fury and anguish for losing a patriot are still very much felt by Filipinos who recently gathered in a solemn ceremony in the San Francisco Bay Area, marking Ninoy's 40th death anniversary. Ken Kashiwahara read a letter he penned for Ninoy, expressing how he felt after he witnessed his own brother-in-law's brutal murder.
It took me a long time to get over the trauma of August 21st. I have never felt such anger and bitterness as I did when I heard those gunshots at the airport, nor such sadness for your friends, your country, and our family.
Event organizer Donnie De Leon hails from Concepcion, Tarlac, Ninoy's hometown. He was only 8 years old in the late 60s when he first encountered Ninoy, who was then campaigning for senator. Even back then, Ninoy had a bigger-than-life persona.
From the sky, a helicopter descended, and out emerged a youthful, handsome, and a captivating politician.
For Lupita Aquino Kashiwahara, Ninoy's sister, it was heartwarming to see those who have witnessed Ninoy's rise to influence come together and share stories to keep his memory alive for generations to come.
Ninoy is now 90 in November, so many of the people that have saw him live and die are also going themselves. But it just goes to show you the 40 years memorial shows exactly how Ninoy is loved in return. Ninoy's legacy will live on, like just like truth will never die. So I mean to say, it will be very nice to continue on his legacy.
The younger Aquinos say they are doing what they can to get their generation to carry on Ninoy's fight for democracy, especially given the current political climate in the Philippines.
We're trying as much as possible to get younger people involved. As you can see, it's a lot of, it's another generation that's the majority of the attendees. We want everybody from all different ages to come together to celebrate what my Lolo Ninoy has done for the Philippines.
For Rob Bonta, the first Filipino-American Attorney General of California, the same things that Ninoy fought for then are still being fought now.
It's important to remember the sacrifice, the courage, the commitment. The tragedy is painful, but it's also a story full of inspiration for the future.
40 years after his death, this community of Filipino-Americans and their allies continue to take to heart Ninoy's ultimate sacrifice, still believing that the Filipino is truly worth dying for. Henni Espinosa, ABS-CBN News, Daly City, California.